Tsunamis can also be caused by underwater landslides or underwater volcanic eruptions. Tsunami waves can be up to 100 feet tall and travel as fast as a jet plane. Tsunami waves begin at one starting point and travel in all directions. At sea, tsunami waves begin at a few inches tall, but as they get closer to shore, they increase in amplitude and decrease in speed. A telltale sign of a tsunami is when the tide gets sucked into the sea, revealing lots of the seafloor. Recognizing this ahead of time as a tsunami can save thousands of lives. Many people don't recognize this as a tsunami and stay on the beach, which can cost them their lives. Tsunami waves are very powerful and have the power to flip boulders, destroy cars, and completely destroy buildings. Tsunami waves can destroy entire villages and leave people without homes, food, electricity, and clean water. After tsunami, the land is covered in debris from cars, structures, and other things, and this can take years to clean up. Many people die after tsunami from disease and lack of resources. The safest thing to do in a tsunami is to travel inland and find higher ground. Another safe place to be in a tsunami is behind a reef, a bay, or a river entrance because they dissipate the energy of the wave and act as a barrier. The biggest tsunami ever recorded had a height of 1,720 feet. It was in Lituya Bay, Alaska on July 9, 1958. The tsunami only killed 5 people. That was because the area had a low population compared to the 230,000 people that died in the 2004 tsunami. The earthquake that caused the 2004 tsunami was thought to have the power of 23,000 atomic bombs. The tectonic plates in the Indian Ocean had been pushing against each other for thousands of years. They will likely keep doing this, which will cause more earthquakes and tsunamis in the future. Unfortunately, there is nothing we can do to stop tsunamis, but there are things we can do to warn people ahead of time. Governments have used systems like water buoys that can detect underwater earthquakes, but not every underwater earthquake results in a tsunami. So many underwater earthquakes that have been detected have ended in a costly evacuation and just a false alarm. But new technology has come out, like the SWASH, which stands for Simulating Waves at Shore, that can calculate how big a wave is, how fast it's moving, and how much energy it holds. A few years ago, I was in Hawaii for spring break with my family. We heard a siren that sounded like a tornado siren, but tornadoes can't hit in Hawaii, so we wondered what could it be. We asked some locals what it was, and they said it was a tsunami siren, but it was just a false alarm. It was because they were just testing it, because it was the beginning of the month. With technology like the SWASH and the tsunami siren, save thousands of lives.